Dear fellow scholars, this is 2-Minute Papers with Károly Zsolnai Fehér. We are over 260 episodes into the series, but believe it or not, we haven't had a single episode on virtual reality. So at this point, you probably know that this paper has to be really good. The promise of virtual reality is indeed truly incredible. Doctors could be trained to perform surgery in a virtual environment, or even perform surgery from afar. We could enhance military training by putting soldiers into better flight simulators, expose astronauts to virtual zero-gravity simulations, you name it. And of course, games. As you see, virtual reality, or VR in short, is on the rise these days, and there is a lot of research going on how to make more killer applications for it. The basics are simple. We put on a VR headset and walk around in our room and perform gestures, and these will be performed in a virtual world by our avatar. Sounds super fun, right? Well, yes. However, we have this headset on, and we don't really see our surroundings within the room, which makes it easy to bump into objects or smash the controller into a wall, which is exactly what I did in the NVIDIA lab in Switzerland not so long ago. My greetings to all the kind people there, and sorry, folks. So, what could be a possible solution? Creating virtual worlds with smaller scales? That kind of defeats the purpose, doesn't it? There has to be a better solution. So how about redirection? Redirection is a simple concept that changes our movement in the virtual world so it deviates from our real path in the room in a way that both lets us explore the virtual world well and not bump into walls and objects in the meantime. Most existing techniques out there either don't do redirection and make us bump into objects and walls within our room, or they do redirection at the cost of introducing distortions and other disturbing changes into the virtual environment. This is not easy to perform well because it has to feel natural, but the changes we apply to the path deviates from what is natural. Here you can see how the blue and orange lines deviate, which means that the algorithm is at work. With this, we can wander about in a huge and majestic virtual landscape, or a cramped bar, even when being confined to a small physical room. Loving the idea. This technique takes into consideration even other moving players in the room and dynamically remap our virtual paths to make sure we don't bump into them. There is a lot more in the paper that describes how the whole method adapts to human perception. Papers like this make me really happy because there are thousands of papers in the domain of human perception within computer graphics, many of which will now see quite a bit of practical use. VR is going to be a huge enabler for this area. Thanks for watching and for your generous support, and I'll see you next time.